فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
My name is Vamik. I'm an accountant in a company here in Dubai. I want to ask you something that whenever I ask for forgiveness in front of Allah, I become very sad and sometimes cry as well in state of Salah. And I get really motivated that I won't commit a sin. But as soon as I go out and join my work or meet with my friends or I have alone time, okay, so I commit sins. Even though I just 15 or 20 minutes ago, I asked for forgiveness. So previously it was not the case. Previously when before 2 or 3 years ago, I used to ask for forgiveness, and this was the motivational factor which used to carry me along a week or a month or maybe 3 months. But now it's only for 15 or 20 minutes. So I really am depressed that most of my time is in the state of sin, and I just have 15 or 20 or maybe 1 hour or 1 day of forgiveness. So
may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you and help us all, and may He guide you and guide us all. My brother, it's a very important point and we have to take it seriously. It is a concern. Firstly, your environment plays a big role in determining what is going to happen after you've engaged in tawbah. So if I've asked Allah for forgiveness from a certain sin, and nothing has changed in my environment, the chances of me falling back into that are probably greater, because I asked Allah to forgive me, but everything that led me to commit those sins is still around me. So together with asking Allah, small changes need to happen. Let's become regular with salah. Let's start becoming in the company of better people. Perhaps let's listen constantly to some talk that's motivating. Wallahi, it helps a lot, a lot. If you listen to something that motivates you, the Quranic recitation, the translation of the Quran, a good lecture, whatever else motivates you, it will help you so much. Keep it constant and keep the dhikr of Allah on your tongue and in your heart, because if you remember Allah a lot, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, it's very, very powerful. It will actually remind you of your duty unto Allah. Similarly, what's important is if your heart is stuck in the house of Allah, like the hadith describes, rajulun qalbuhu mu'allaqun bil masajid, a man whose heart is stuck in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you are constantly concerned about the next salah, and you arrive a little bit early in the masjid, you make your wudu, that will help you a lot. It will bring up about so much calmness. And sometimes we work in an environment that is perhaps, you know, not so encouraging of our salah. Maybe we have mates who are not too bothered. They may be not be Muslim at all. It might be a workplace that may not be encouraging, you know, a person to fulfill their salah on time. It's up to us to find a way and to build a, you know, a method of how I'm going to work and how I will find my moments for salah, who I will read salah with. What I have found very beneficial is when you are more than one, then you and you think similar, it's far easier for you to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, if we are moving two people, the minute the time for salah comes, you look at each other and you say, time for salah. It's done. When you're alone, sometimes you say, okay, let me find the next masjid, and then you're looking for it. Shaitan might come and make you delay and something might happen. So it's important for us to establish a whole you know, range of items that would inshallah progress. Like I've said, I've given just a few options. We ask Allah's forgiveness, and at the same time ensure your environment, your friends, whatever you listen to, your habits and so on, inshallah it can change. But there's one last point I want to say. You know, you might find it strange, but it's reality. If your tawbah is making you motivated for 20 minutes, seek tawbah after 20 minutes again and get another 20. You know, it's like a parking ticket. You put it 1 hour later, you need to put a bit more. Another hour later, otherwise you get a fine. So it, before, like you say, and wallahi, I salute your courage to have said this thing open. But it happens to all of us that sometimes, you know, you need a bit of a recharge of a battery. I spoke about it, giving the example of the phone, that the battery dies or it comes low. When it gets to 10%, it tells you to recharge. Same applies with us. When our you know, that tawbah and the feeling we felt is driving a little bit low, that boost we need, plug it in again, go to the masjid, meet a good man, meet someone, you know, do something good, try and read a good book, motivation, the Quran, the recitation, something that motivates you, keep it going. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all, and may He make us from amongst those who can be motivated to do good. Wallahi, you are so correct. It's very difficult in this environment of materialism. Everything is about money, everything is about perfume, everything is about lovely things and flashy items, everything is about the latest and the latest, in such a way that we forget to turn to Allah. And by the time we start gaining focus, you know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, we don't want to be from amongst those who've died in the condition that we haven't yet got that focus. And that's why we have the talk this evening. There are so many things that I wanted to say, honestly, but time just flew, because I was thinking, subhanallah, ya Allah, I will start saying whatever I have, and inshallah we'll keep the rest for another time perhaps. So many things that I haven't said that I wanted to say this evening, but a little bit at a time. Jazakallah khair, my brother.
One thing I just want to say, that
is it connected to what you just said?
Yeah, just do dua for me, please.
Barakallah fiqh. The dua we did right at the beginning, I started with it, to say, may Allah guide me and guide you. Yes. And help us all, inshallah. We are all in one boat, my brother.
As-salam.